Good Sunday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick look at what's going on with the forecast. If you're just joining us, this is our way of getting the information out to you when it comes to what's going on with the weather. We continue again to monitor what's happening around West Tennessee, North Mississippi, and back into around areas of eastern Arkansas. And so far for this morning, things have been decently quiet, but we continue again to see the possibility of more chances of showers and thunderstorms in the Mid-South as we go into the rest of the day. Got questions about the forecast from the Mid-South area, or if you're in the Mid-South, let's see your weather reports. Drop them into the section, the comment section, and let us know what things are like where you are. And don't forget to check out our website at WREG.com/weather. Current conditions in the News Channel 3 backyard here, forecast for today here, and forecast for tonight, lower section of your screen down here, mid to upper 50s for the metro area later on tonight, and temperatures back into around the upper 70s for later on today. Normal for this time of the year, roughly about 80 degrees, so we're going to be just below that. So a nice treat where the temperature is concerned, and looking very nice as we go into the course of the next few days after that. But we still do have some showers and thunderstorms to deal with. We're going to have that 20% coverage chance out there throughout the course of the rest of the day. So if you have any plans for outdoors, it is possible that you're going to be needing the umbrella at some point in time. But most of the chances of rainfall, again, should be relatively on the light side for right now. And it's going to be, again, the possibility of, again, later this morning where we pick up the possibility of a few showers and thunderstorms here and there. Best possibility will be in the early to mid-morning hours, and then afterwards we see things kind of drift away where that moisture is concerned, the clouds and the rainfall and everything else heading on out of the picture back in the lower 70s as we go toward lunchtime today. So looking pretty nice out there throughout the rest of the morning. You can see some of that clearing going on if you take a look at the picture from in and around the area of Germantown, around the area looking back toward the horizon. You can see again a little bit of clearing going on there. That's again the sky starting to break up by just a little bit, but in the meantime we've got plenty of cloud cover out there today. Rhodes College in Memphis from the Weather Underground System showing again a beautiful start to the morning, quiet and a little bit on the cloudy side. Mineral Wells, Mississippi, Tim B's webcam also on the Weather Underground System showing a lot of green and a lot of gray skies up above that particular location near Olive Branch. Windeye Country Club, ground crew out and ready to go, getting things taken care of for the golfers that will be showing up here in the next couple of hours, but not seeing too many golfers out and about on the course just yet. Still will be chances of showers and a few thunderstorms out across portions of the area. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little while. We are still here at the screen freeze. This happens every once in a while. The computer has to play catch up. We're dealing with a computer system that has a lot of data into it with the clouds and the rainfall and everything else. So what we're going to be seeing again for today, let me zoom out so that we can get everybody taken care of here. Mid to upper 60s to lower 70s as we go through around the early portion of the morning into late this morning. Temperatures will continue to rise going back again into around the mid to upper 60s or so, but we will not be seeing too much of anything in the way of major amounts of problems with rainfall out across much of the area. So again, isolated areas of showers and maybe a few thunderstorms taking place early on, but that is going to be about it. And then for the rest of the day today, temperatures will be again rather on the mild side, back into about the mid to upper 70s to the lower 80s across much of the area. So warm day coming up, not as warm as it could be for this time of the year, but noticeably on the mild side. Drier air starts to swoop its way in throughout the rest of the day, coming in from the northwest, and that'll keep the temperatures down by just a little bit. So a beautiful evening tonight. Early tomorrow morning, a few clouds drifting on through by the time the kids head to school, for those of you who still have school out there, and then getting into the rest of Monday. Temperatures back in the mid to upper 70s to lower 80s. Now, the computer model brings in a chance of rainfall late on Monday evening. It doesn't look like much at this time. Most of the opportunities for rainfall will be after midnight on Tuesday, so we should see a little bit of activity there, but probably not by much. Showers and thunderstorms early, then clearing for the rest of the day today. Numbers back into about the mid to upper 70s for highs today and tomorrow. We'll be looking for clearing skies on Monday, at least clearer than what we have seen for a while, and that'll get us at least a little bit of sunshine out there. But temperatures will remain very mild into Monday, very much on the mild side. There are temperatures as we go into Tuesday also in the mid to upper 70s. Now the chances of showers and thunderstorms should wait on until most of Tuesday has gone by. The computer there in the previous animation that you saw kind of bringing in the chances of rain a little bit on the early side, so it's again a little enthusiastic on that. I'm thinking right now that the chances of rainfall are going to be waiting until about Tuesday instead of late Monday, so keep it tuned to News Channel 3 for any updates on the forecast. Again, things can change on these numbers every single day, and they often do, so you need to check back and see what's going on there. Rest of the forecast into REM. The rest of the area for today and the next several days, cooler as we go toward Wednesday. Decent little burst of cool air heading our direction, and we should see again the possibilities of showers and thunderstorms out of the picture after Wednesday. Thursday and Friday look pretty good, and then by Saturday next, another chance of showers and thunderstorms starts to make their way into the mid-south area. It doesn't look like much at this time, 10-20% coverage chance at best, but if you have outdoor plans for next weekend, that might not be a bad idea to get a plan B ready to go just to be on the safe side. So stay tuned to News Channel 3 either on air or online, and we'll keep you updated on that. Also, don't forget about our weather app. Whatever platform you've got, go to your app store and search WREG Weather and find out more about what it is that our app can do for you. Tons of weather information available. I've got it, use it every single day. Great opportunity to see more about lightning and the satellite pictures that we have out there, even earthquake data. It's all available out there, again, through our weather app. You can get that wreg.com/weather, more information there. If you can't go online or watch on our TV broadcast or cable or satellite, either way, listen to our forecast, Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3 for more information throughout the rest of the weekend. And of course, I'll be on bright and early tomorrow morning on Yahoo Sports Radio AM 730 with Bob and Josh on Talkback Live for more weather information. Great sports chat available, so drop by and listen in and see what you can get for the forecast there. And also don't forget, tons of information on my various social media networks are all out there. And if you've got weather pictures, send them along. We would love to pass them along on our News Channel 3 social media network so everybody can see what your photographic skills are like. And it'd be great to see some pictures from around the Mid-South. Some incredible works last night of sunset. And if you've got anything like that, please let us know and send it along. Should be an email address at the bottom of the screen right here. Should say austin.onek@wreg.com. So again, a good opportunity for you to send along anything. If you'd like to see something on here, let me know, and I would love to be able to accommodate everybody on here. If there's weather overseas you want to see, that's great. Space weather, we can do that. Anything like that, we'd love to help you out, but you have to let me know about that. So let me know at austin.onek@wreg.com. I got to finish this up because we've got another weather hit coming up at the quarter hour, so join me live on the broadcast. Nina Harrelson, my co-anchor, is out there right now giving you this morning's news, and I'll have more on the forecast coming up here in just a little while on air, so stay tuned for that. Also coming up at the top of the hour, 7 a.m., join me on our Facebook page, our main WREG Facebook page, facebook.com/WREG3, and I'd be glad to give you an update as to what's going on with the forecast there. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee at the WREG News Channel 3 Severe Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us on Periscope and Twitter for a live broadcast, netcast, whatever you want to call it, of our exclusive video weather blog called Weather Overtime, and stick around for more with News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the weekend for all your weather, news, and sports updates.